Hello students, welcome to Abhipedia. I'm Alka Verma. I'm a professor of economics and I have a teaching experience of 23 years. Today, I'm going to discuss with you how monetary policy can play an effective role and an important role in the economic development of a country. And what I'm going to tell you is what is monetary policy, what are the objectives of monetary policy, how they are pursued in times of inflation, what should be the appropriate monetary policy during deflation, what should be appropriate monetary policy, then how it helps in economic stability and economic development of a country. So, what is monetary policy? Monetary policy is pursued by the central bank of a country with reference to supply of money, availability of money, and also the cost of money. Or in simple words, we can say that monetary policy is with reference to quantity of money and quality of money. Quantity of money is naturally the supply and availability of money, and quality of money is with reference to rate of interest. Now, there are certain objectives focusing on growth and stability of the economy, and that we try to achieve with the help of monetary policy. Now, what are the objectives? First objective is full employment. Now, in a country like underdeveloped economy, we are all aspiring to achieve full employment in our economy. Second objective is economic growth, and it refers to process of sustained rise in the real per capita income. So, monetary policy helps to accelerate the rate of economic growth in the economy. Then price stability. We have wide fluctuations in our prices, price level. So we need to have stability in our prices so that there can be more economic growth of the country. Then exchange stability. That is also another objective of a monetary policy. We need to have stability in our balance of payment. Supposing our imports are more than our export, then we have adverse balance of payment and it will have bad impact on exchange rate also. So, we try to bring about stability in our exchange rate. Then also, another objective is reduction in the economic inequalities in our country. We know that there is extreme inequalities. Some are very rich and some are very poor. So, with the help of monetary policy, the government tries to bridge the gap between the rich and the poor. So basically, with these objectives, monetary policy tries to accelerate the rate of economic growth. Monetary policy tries to bring about economic development. All right, and so that is the basic. These are the basic objectives of a monetary policy. Now, let me tell you that how monetary policy becomes effective during inflation. Now, what is inflation? Inflation is persistent rise in the price level, and basically when the demand is more than the supply, then it leads to increase in the price level. So a persistent rise in the price level, that is what is known as inflation. Now what monetary policy does to curtail inflation? Now first, it will restrain the new currency, because a central bank has got the sole authority of printing new notes. So, in case of inflation, in that case, naturally, there will be restriction in the supply of new currency. They will restrain supplying the new currency, printing new currency. Then, they will increase the rate of interest so that money becomes expensive and people will take less loan for both consumption purpose as well as productive purpose. Then, credit control methods, they are applied by the central bank. And quantitative credit control methods are bank rate. If bank rate is high, then market rate of interest will also be high. And if market rate of interest will be high, naturally the cost of money will be high. So people will shy to take loans. Secondly, we have open market operation. Then we have SLR. Then we have cash reserve ratios. These are the quantitative methods of credit control adopted by a central bank when they try to pursue their monetary policy to combat inflation. Then we have qualitative methods of credit control also, like margin requirements, Then we have moral suasion, direct action. So all these instruments of monetary policy, they are applied effectively to control inflation. Bank rate will be increased, open market operation will be reduced, then cash reserve ratio will be increased. This way, it will curtail the supply of money. And if supply of money is less in the economy, naturally, the demand will also be less. And if demand is less, it will lead to decrease in the price level. And next, demonetization. You already know, you have experienced demonetization. So government, during inflation, the central bank, through its monetary policy, pursues demonetization and issues new currency in place of old currency. Of course, the old currency can be exchanged, but to certain amount only. So in that case, it helps us to naturally wipe off the black money. And if black money is less, naturally it will lead to less demand, and less demand will automatically lead to less price. So basically, the intention towards inflation is to decrease the price level by decreasing the demand. And that can be pursued by the monetary policy very effectively. Now, after that, monetary policy can also play a very important role in combating deflation. Now, what is deflation? Deflation is when the prices are falling, employment is also falling, or in other words, simple words, we can say that supply is less than demand. So that is what is the situation of deflation. And that is also bad, because unemployment is not only an economic problem, it's more a social problem. So we have to combat that. In that case, naturally, the monetary policy would be different. Monetary policy, naturally, they will liberalize the policy of note issue. More money will be issued in the economy through deficit financing, so that it increases the purchasing power of the people. It will help us to increase the demand. And if aggregate demand will increase, it will lead to more income, more output, more employment, and it will help to combat the deflation. Then secondly, there should be reduction in the cost of money. How? Naturally, the rate of interest will be reduced according to the monetary policy pursued by the central bank. Rate of interest will be less, the cost of money will be less, so it will be naturally, credit will be given to the people and at less rate, so that will stimulate investment, that will stimulate production, that will stimulate consumption. Then there should be easy availability of credit also to combat deflationary situation. So this way a monetary policy can play an important role to combat deflation, and naturally we can have more economic growth if we are able to face the situations properly. Then monetary policy can also play a very important role in the stability of exchange rate. Now exchange rate can be stable only when our balance of payment is in balance. And monetary policy plays a very important role in stabilizing the exchange rate. Now, how it helps? Now, supposing we have our imports are more than exports. That means we have adverse balance of payment. In that case, naturally, money supply has to be reduced. Then money supply will be less, price level will be less. All right, then price level will be less, aggregate demand will be less. In that case, imports will be less. Imports will be less than export. Then in that case, naturally, we can reduce the import and we can have balance in our balance of payment. And monetary policy will help us to bring about stability in our exchange rate. Then second parameter, we can say that parameter of cost of money. So in this case, according to the monetary policy that should be pursued to bring about stability would be to reduce the cost of money. And how they are going to reduce the cost of money? They will reduce the rate of interest. If rate of interest is less, then in that case, naturally, foreign direct investment will flow in our country. There will be inflow of foreign direct investment. And because of that, naturally, we can have balance in our balance of payment and we can have stability in our exchange rate. And third one is availability of money. This is third parameter, how they can bring about, monetary policy can bring about stability. So in this case, cheap credit should be available to the exporters. Then only we can have more exports. And then this way, we can have balance in our balance of payment. And also, our exchange rate will be stable. Now, monetary policy and economic development. How it helps in economic development of a country. An appropriate monetary policy helps economic development of the country by adjusting the supply of money to the needs of development. Because in an underdeveloped economy, we need resources. There is resource crunch. So monetary policy can help in adjusting the supply of money to the various needs of the economy. And then capital formation and improvement in technology. These are the main prerequisites for economic development. Capital formation can take place when there is enough money in the economy, supply of money is more, and then we can pursue cheap money policy, we can make use of all instruments of monetary policy. Then besides that, it will encourage investment, rate of interest should be reduced, more supply of money should be there, it will encourage investment. And then besides that, investment will lead to capital formation, and capital formation will lead to economic development of a country. But for this, savings must precede investment. More saving will lead to more investment will lead to more capital formation and more economic development. Now, how monetary policy can play an important role in increasing the rate of saving? First, number one is mobilization of saving. And for this, we need to have more financial institutions across the country, in every nook and corner of the country. More financial institutions, then we can tap more potential saving. And these institutions will help us to mobilize the potential saving. And these savings can be effectively used for investment, and investment will lead to capital formation. Besides that, we should have this deposit insurance scheme also to have inspired more confidence among the savers, among the depositors. And then for capital formation, cheap monetary policy should be followed. Cheap monetary policy means the rate of interest should be reduced, supply of money should be more. So this way we can pursue cheap money policy, and it can lead to more economic growth, more investment, more capital formation. And then besides that, for economic development, we also need price stability. For a price stability, sustained growth of an economy needs price stability. Without price stability, it's difficult to have sustained growth of the economy. We can't have sustained growth for a longer duration if we do not have price stability. So price stability, monetary policy can play a very, very effective role during inflation as well as deflation to bring about stability. And this is going to help us to have price stability in the economy, growth of the economy. Then besides that, it can also help in the utilization of excess capacity. Underdeveloped countries like India, we have excess capacity. We can produce more, but there is lack of resources. So this monetary policy, by reducing the rate of interest, by pursuing cheap money policy, by increasing the supply of money, they can, more investment can be made, and we can make use of the excess capacity. So there should be availability of cheap credit also. So this way it can help us to use, to make the optimum utilization of whatever excess capacity we have. And this can lead to increase in the supply of goods and services in the economy, moderate the inflation, and it will also help in economic development of a country, because more goods will be added in our consumption basket. So finally, we can conclude that monetary policy can play a very crucial role in the process of growth and development of both the developed countries as well as less developed countries like India. In developed countries, naturally, it helps in moderating the impact of trade cycle. That is boom, that is recession, that is depression, that is recovery. In underdeveloped country, not only it moderates the trade cycle, operation of trade cycle, but it also helps us in economic development by tapping the resources of investment. It stimulates saving, it stimulates investment, it leads to capital formation. So an appropriate monetary policy can play a crucial role in the economic development of a country. Thank you. And if you have liked the lecture, and if you have understood the concepts of monetary policy, how it is so effective in economic growth and development of a country, please subscribe to Abhipedia and kindly share this video. Thank you.
Last one of the